لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في
أعوذ
الدنيا
بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على مبعوث رحمة للعالمين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعوا بالإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إخوتي الأفاضل، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First of all, we thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we testify that there is none worthy of praise and worship except Allah, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final seal of all prophets and messengers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pour his peace and mercy and blessings upon him, ya Kareem. My dear respectable brothers and sisters in the deen, welcome to another episode of our weekly sessions here at the North Brixton Islamic Cultural Center in London. Tonight, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala, our topic is the impact and the virtues of istighfar. Istighfar, seeking forgiveness. What's the impact, the virtues of this wonderful, wonderful topic today? And with me, I have the humble Sheikh Dr. Faisal Bouadi, who will take us through all this, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala. As usual, I will recite the Quran to you, few ayats from the Quran, which is going to be from chapter 3, verse 133 to verse 136. After the recitation, then I will narrate to you the nutshell meaning of this ayat, these verses, and thereafter I will pass the mic to the Ibul Sheikh. As I mentioned, we're going to look at, inshallah, the meaning of istighfar linguistically and in our own applied topic tonight, and also as well the position or the importance of this istighfar, and how to say istighfar, how do we say it, what are the different methods of that. And we're going to look at the condition of istighfar bi'ithnillahi ta'ala, and we're going to look at the athar al-istighfar ala nafs, the impact of that istighfar on the soul itself. How does he play or applies on the soul? What impact does he have on myself, on you, if he says istighfar? And nataij al-istighfar as well, the results of istighfar. What are the results? What do we gain from it? And also as well, afdal awqati, what are the best time for us to say istighfar? And then what are the afdal istighfar? What are the best istighfar we should say? These are the things we're going to look at, inshallah. Akbar. Yeah, akbar mushkilatina. Then we're going to look at this istighfar in collaboration to our own major problems today in our own contemporary world. So these are the things, inshallah, we're going to cover, and I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of us. So without much ado, I'm going to recite the ayat now and narrate the natural meaning of this ayat, and then I will pass the mic to the Hubul Sheikh. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض عدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاذبين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين. Allah says, وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم. He said, hasten, be quick, hurry up and you race each other towards seeking forgiveness from your Lord. Always rush and be quick to seek forgiveness from your Lord. That's what Allah says here to you. He said, وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا, because the paradise that we are talking about or we read about in the Quran, Allah talks about عَرْضُهَا, its width. The width of at al-Jannah, as-samawat wal-ard, is like the sky above and the earth below. وَعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, this paradise is prepared for those who are God conscious. May Allah make us be amongst them, Ya Kareem. And who are these people who are God conscious? Allah mentioned the people who are going to inherit this paradise. They're going to inherit it. But these are the characteristics of these people. Allah said, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ, these are the ones who spend their wealth في السراء, during happy times. When they receive good news, when they are happy, when they are going through 14 times, mashallah, they spend their wealth. وَالدَّرَّى, and even when they are going through trials, difficult times, misfortunes, they still spend their wealth in the cause of Allah. وَالْكَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْثِ, and these are the ones who restrain their anger when they are oppressed, when they face situation whereabouts they have all the ability to stress or show their anger or express it, but rather they restrain it because of Allah. So they restrain, they hold on to their anger, they don't get angry. And not only that, Allah said, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and they pardon, they forgive one another. When they are oppressed by someone, they forgive them. Allah said, وَاللَّهُ, because Allah, يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, He loved those who show kindness to people, especially to those who have wronged them. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً, these are the ones, whenever they come across or they do an act of indecency, أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ, or they wronged their own souls, ذَكَرُوا اللَّهُ, immediately after they've made mistakes, they remember Allah. Immediately after committing that sin, they remember Allah. They call upon Allah. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ, and they will seek forgiveness immediately, saying, Astaghfirullah. Because وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, because they know that no one will forgive their sins except who? Allah. But Allah said, وَلَمْ يُسِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا, they will not persist, continue doing the mistakes they've done. وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ, while they are aware or willingly doing it. Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ, such people, جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً, their reward will be forgiveness, مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ, from their Lord. وَجَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, and they will receive or they will be accommodated, admitted in Al-Jannah. Underneath the Al-Jannah, you have fountains flowing underneath. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they will stay in Al-Jannah therein forever. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ, what a beautiful reward for those who work hard. May Allah make us be amongst them. May their brothers and sisters in the deen, without much ado, I'll pass the mic now to the Sheikh for him to take us through this wonderful ayat. فَلِتَبَدَّلَ Sheikh مَشْكُورًا.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala ashraf al-Mursaleen. Nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we are still alive. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you for coming, and whatever you have left behind, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take care of that for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the angels come and seek forgiveness for us. Brothers and sisters, today, as I said, Hayabina Nazhab ila Hadiqatul Istighfar. Come, let us go to the garden of forgiveness. So today you are going to the garden of forgiveness. so that you can pick the fruits, the beautiful and the sweet fruits that you have in it. Bi'iznillahi ta'ala. It is a very long topic that you cannot finish it in within a distance. It's a very, very long topic. But inshallah, so far, nadanda la hawla ba'da nuqat bi'iznillahi ta'ala. Inshallah. All right. The first and foremost, you have to know the definition of istighfar. What is the meaning of istighfar? Istighfar, you can say, is forgiveness. It's come from ghafar. Ghafar is, you know, the shield that people they put either on their head or in front of them, you know, the tongues, when they are fighting to cover them so that the weapons cannot come straight into their bodies. Okay? So this one is where it comes from. That is the linguistic meaning of istighfar. That means something that prevents and cover you from something to happen to you. That is istighfar. So, what is the connection? What is the meaning, the real meaning, istilahiyya, shar'iyyan? The theological meaning, what does that mean? It means an individual seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sins that he or she had committed. Why? Because the sins that he commit, it prevents us for something, for us to achieve something. Like one man, he said, "Oh, I find it very difficult. Whenever I try, I make my intention to wake up in the night to pray Salat Tahajjud. But I could not. I just sleep all the time." So the Imam Ahmed told him that, he said, "You know why?" He said, "No." He said, "Kayyadaka dhunubak." He said, "Your sins had pinned you down. The sins that you commit, it has pinned you down that you could not get up in the night to perform tahajjud." So you can see. So istighfar, it will take away that kind of thing from you so that you become free. And the tawbah, the difference between istighfar and the tawbah, what's the meaning of tawbah? Tawbah means what? In English? Repentance. Very good. Repentance. What is repentance? As you know, it has two syllables, isn't it? The same thing like forgiveness. Okay? For mean, it means you have the power. The power is in your hand. You can do whatever thing you want to do at this time. But he said, give. Give away that power. In other words, do not make that power take its place. Okay? And repentance, everybody knows the meaning of pent, isn't it? What's the meaning of pent? Pent means what?
Two words there. You have re, you have pent. Yeah. What's the meaning of pent?
What's the meaning of pent? You don't know the meaning of pent? You say repentance, repentance. You don't know what's the meaning of pent? You see, Marfa to say, Faru, Tasawur. You know, when you know the description and so forth about something, then it makes you know exactly what this thing is about. Pent is high, that's why I say penthouse. Have you ever seen penthouse before?
Yes.
Where? Where did you see penthouse?
Boxall, there's one in Boxall.
Yeah. Okay, so next time you visit there, so you do not forget it. Inshallah. So penthouse is the house that is built on what? The height. Good. Re means what? Re. It means what? Huh? To do?
Someone said to repeat.
Somebody reverse. Says to repeat.
And the other one said to reverse.
Which one?
I like that. So which one?
Which one shall you go? With? Shall you go?
Shall we reverse?
Shall you reverse?
Reverse.
Huh?
Repeat again. When repeat, should repeat the
so, we'll go reverse.
Well, it should go forward.
Mashallah, that's very pretty. I love it. Good. Re means return. So return to the pent. Return to the height. When you commit sin, it brings you down, as the man was, Imam Ahmed was telling the man. It pins you down. Okay? So what is now? You are master of yourself. You have to take off what is pinning you down now. That is asking, as soon as you get it from you, you take off that, it takes you away. Oh. Good. So this is just a nutshell. But what's the difference then in terms of this? Forgiveness, istighfar, and tawbah, and repentance. It is very simple. Okay, how simple it is. When your dress or clothes becomes very dirty, what do you put perfumes on it? What do? You wash it with what? Water and what? Why? It makes it clean, mashallah. Good. And when you have become clean and so forth, then you do what? You put what? Perfume. You understand? So istighfar is the clothes that are very dirty. They are very, very dirty. The sins that you have committed and so forth, it has smell. It smells so bad. So he said, wash it. Ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? And when you have got that one, then you come to the next part of it. So this one, you have it, tatwir wa ta'tir. You understand it, isn't it? Tatwir and ta'tir. Meaning, you clean this clothes, you make it so nice, so beautiful, you wash it, and then you put perfume on it. That perfume is the tawbah. The perfume that you put on the clothes that have been washed, that is the tawbah. So you understand the difference between istighfar and tawbah? You understand? So which one comes first? Tawbah or istighfar? Oh, somebody said tawbah. She has gone up above you. You say istighfar. She said no, it's tawbah. Well, it was a lot of good. Yes, which one comes first? Istighfar? Seeking forgiveness comes first? Then repentance?
Repentance first.
Yes. Huh? Repentance first. Any kind of a sin is a big in the sight of Allah. Yeah, they are all majors. He said, don't do it. Who told you? The one who told you, so everyone is a major in the sight of Allah. Yes. So which one comes first? Istighfar comes first. You have to wash the clothes from that, what? from the dirt. And then after that, you put perfume on it. And that is the Tawbah. So you have Tatbir and Ta'atir, both of them. They have to go together. All right. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you come to the hukum, the injunction of istighfar. What is it wajib, is it fard, is it mustahab, is it haram, or jaiz?
Is it compulsory to seek forgiveness?
Yes. In other words, we are entering into fiqh istighfar. Is it compulsory?
No.
To seek forgiveness?
No.
Well, if you fear Allah, if you have the fear of Allah, then it's compulsory.
Okay. All right. Or is it something mustahab? Wanted to do it?
You do it.
Or is it something haram?
It's not haram.
It's not haram.
It's not haram.
No.
For your own benefit. So you seek istighfar only when you commit sin, isn't it?
No.
Even though you don't commit a sin.
Because you don't know.
You don't know which sins you've committed.
That
seems that you're not aware of.
Exactly.
Is that?
Yes. Yes.
MashaAllah. That, you see, when the MashaAllah Fuqaha, MashaAllah, the jurist, everybody is saying, yeah, it's very pretty. I love that one. Yes.
Talk about the eyes, the tongue, some things you say.
Yeah.
Might be seen for and don't even realize.
Okay.
Let's.
Without sin.
Yeah.
Okay. All
right.
Okay. All right. It is good. In other words, it is, but according to this ayah, you all check the first ayah. And what did it say? You tell me what it is.
It said be quick in grace for forgiveness.
What does that mean? Is it a command? Is this a recommendation? Is it something which is permissible?
I think it's a recommendation because asking for forgiveness is not compulsory.
But according to the verse. I'm talking about the verse.
Can we look at the verse? It's chapter 3. Chapter 3, verse 1 through 3. Is it a command?
It's a command.
Yes.
Good. Very good. He said, be quick. Hurry up. Do it. Very good. So seeking forgiveness is a compulsory. Seeking forgiveness is compulsory for a believer. You must seek a forgiveness. It is important. Okay. But as you said, should I seek forgiveness? Only when I have committed a sin or not? No. So, it is any time. Because when you go to the toilet and you come out, what do you say? What do you say? Gufranak. What does that mean? Astaghfirullah. I don't understand Astaghfirullah. What is the meaning of Astaghfirullah? Oh, may Allah forgive you. So going to the toilet is something bad for you to do. For Allah to forgive you for going to the toilet. So what is the connection here? What has that in seeking forgiveness and going to the toilet? What kind of relation between them? Because you have made a mistake in the toilet. Okay, that is very pretty. Because before you enter the toilet, what do you say? All right. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you. From what? From the male and female what?
Jinns,
bad ones and so forth. Okay. All right. That is what you do. And now you came out, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. The forgiveness meaning here, what you have done inside and then you came out now. Okay? You are now praying to Allah to forgive you because Allah has protected you that these jinns, they did not attack you inside there. If they have attacked you, mashallah, you will know what will have happened to you. So now you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you in front of you in the sins that you may be committing, inshallah, after you have been protected. Okay, so here you are. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about what Allah will give it to you and me when you seek forgiveness. What can we gain from it? Allah said, yes, in the same ayah, Allah will give us the Jannah, isn't it? So that one becomes one of samarat. That means the main samarat of that, the fruit that you gain from that garden of forgiveness. Okay? Allah will give you, provide you with Al-Jannah. And not only that, after all that, Allah had said, those people who go away from things that Allah had forbidden them to do and so forth, but at the end of it, what Allah is going to give you to them, when you come to the last ayah, 136, what Allah is going to give you to them? Huh? Allah says He's going to give them what? Forgiveness. And when you have been forgiven, where are you going to? Jannah. Bi-iznillahi ta'ala, may Allah make us among those people. Good. So now you have known the importance of it. Okay. Let's see who was the first person to ask forgiveness. Adam alayhi salam and his wife. Are you sure? Iblis did not? Iblis never asked for forgiveness. But Adam alayhi salam, he did. Adam alayhi salam, he did. So when you go to Surah Al-A'raf, which is Quran chapter 7, verse 23, that was the first istighfar, chapter 7.
Chapter 7, verse 23, Surah Al-A'raf. This is about the first person to seek forgiveness on earth. Person, human. Chapter 7, verse 23. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قال يا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. قال آدم عليه السلام and Hawa, our mother, both of them seek forgiveness from Allah. They said, ربنا, O Allah, O our Lord, ظلمنا أنفسنا, we have wronged our souls. وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا, if you do not forgive us, وَتَرَحَمْنَا, and have mercy on us, لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, we shall certainly be amongst the losers.
So this dua is very, very important. That's the first istighfar. Can you all say it?
The thing is, it was like when we were eating, I don't know what to say, like it is something and this one doesn't rhyme with each other. Please, can we just say it nicely? Because this is the dua Allah taught Adam to say. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Say it once more, then you say it, inshallah. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Okay, can you say it? Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Once more, please. I had that lana kakauna. We don't have cacao here. Please, subhanallah. This is the most important dua. Huh? We don't have lana kakauna. No. Lanakunanna. Aha, it's not lana kakauna. We don't have cacao. Now, say it once more again. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Okay, say it once more, please. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin.
Mashallah, good. Now you have 100%, mashallah. Yes, now you can tap.
Stop talking, please.
That is very pretty. I love it. Good. May Allah bless all of you. May Allah accept this dua also that you have made. It is so important. Now, apart from that, we have, when we look at our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell him to do? Go to Surah Hud, which is Quran chapter 11, verse 1 to 3. Chapter 11, verse 1 to 3.
Surah Hud. Chapter 11, from verse 1. Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام را كتاب أحكمت آياته ثم فصلت من لدن حكيم خبير ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إنني لكم منه نذير وبشير وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يمتعكم متاعا حسنا إلى أجل مسمى ويؤتي كل ذي فضل فضله وإن تولوا فإني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم كبير. الله سيز Alif, Lam, Ra. Allah knows best the meaning of this ayah, these letters. Kitabun uhkimat ayatu. Allah said these are fundamental verses, which of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have established the meaning, which has further explanation in detail. And of course, Allah said, Thumma fussilat min ladun hakeemin khabir. It's been further explained in detail from the one who is wise and well acquainted with all things by Allah. Alla ta'budu illa Allah. That you must not worship except who? Except Allah. Innani lakum minhu nadhirun wa bashir. That verily, say to them that verily, and that was a message or instruction to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that tell the people that Alla ta'budu illa Allah. You must not worship except who? Allah. Innani, that I myself here, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lakum, to you, minhu nadhirun mubin. I come from Allah. I've been sent by Allah to be what? Nadhir, to be a warner, admonish you, and also as well, bashir wa bashir, and to give you glad tidings. When you obey Allah, this is what you will achieve. And the third verse, Allah said, this is a command. Wa an istaghfiru rabbakum. You have been commanded. Look, a command. You have been commanded to seek forgiveness from your Lord. Thumma tubu ilay. You see, you remember what Sheikh was saying? What comes first? Allah said, an istaghfiru rabbakum. For you to seek forgiveness from your Lord, thumma then tubu ilay. Turn to Him in repentance again and again. And then, if you do that, the result is this. Yumatti'ukum mata'an hasana. Allah will give you an enjoyment. He will grant you enjoyment and goodness of this world. Ila ajalin musayyuti kulla dhi fadlin fadla. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bestow His grace abundantly on those, you know, who repent to Him. Of course, we'll do it in abundantly, in a high rank, in good merits or in the merits. Wa in tawallaw, Allah said, but if you turn away, you don't seek forgiveness. The Prophet said, Allah said to him, say, فَإِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ كَبِيرٍ. He said, I'm afraid that if you turn away from Allah, you don't seek forgiveness, the punishment of Allah will befall on you the greater day. And that is the day of judgment. May Allah save us from that.
MashaAllah. So now you have known the benefit of seeking forgiveness. You have to seek forgiveness. Even Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told his people that we must seek what? Forgiveness. And then, what are you supposed to do? Repent unto Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. The result, the benefit of it will be Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will provide you with all kinds of enjoyment. What's the enjoyment about here? And he said, Hasanan, the best and all kinds of good enjoyment. Your sight, you can see with it. Your ears, you can hear with it. Your nose, you can smell with it. We had one man who was a millionaire, and this man, he spent his lot of his money all over the world, just to be able to smell. He could not smell. Yeah. So one sheikh asked him, he said, if it's in case, I get you one doctor who can make you to smell, what, how much are you going to pay? He said, I'll give him millions. Just to be able to do what? To smell.
And we take it for granted.
And we took it for granted. He spent most millions. He could not until he died. Until he died. Now, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, if you seek forgiveness and you repent, He will make you to enjoy all these things that He has given to you. And if you're not, He can take them away from you, and nobody can bring it back to you, isn't it?
Yes.
As simple as that. As simple as that. But, so, the not only that, he will also give you his abundant a lot of grace. Father, so many things of your children, of your household, everything that we be doing and so forth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you with it. Isn't that beautiful? And all on is what? Istighfar, seeking forgiveness.
Just to
seek forgiveness. There was one student, some of you may know it and so forth, they call it Ijazat Million. Ijazat Million. That means 1 million holiday. This student, he told one sheikh, he said, now we have our summer holidays. Our summer holidays, when you were in the university, what I said, about 3 months. You take 3 months because the weather is very, very hot. It's not, so 3 months. So this student, he said, I am going to spend this holidays by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making the zikr 1 million times. So the sheikh told him, he said, why are you picking? Because this one is very difficult for you. 1 million times is not easy. He said, yes, I will do it, inshallah. Eventually, he did it until when he saw the sheikh again after the holidays. He said, what did you do? Were you able to? He said, yes, I was able to do it, and I was able even to do more. Subhanallah, 1 million istighfar. Why? It is our mind. You see the mind? That is what keeps us down or makes us go. Whatever signal you put it here, the rest of the bodies, they take it. If it's a positive signal, they go with it. If it's a negative, oh, I cannot go. The body said, yes, man, we are all living tired. Forget it. Then sit down. You sit. Oh, I don't care. It is even raining, mashallah. It's barakah. I'm going to the lecture. The rest of the body said, yes, you are going. You are going with you. So the positive and the negative signal that you send to your body, that is how the rest or the members of the body also act upon. And he was able to do it. At the end, the sheikh asked him, what kind of benefit did you gain after all this? He said, sheikh, he said, I cannot even tell you. He said, anything I ask Allah, I don't know. It just comes like that. Anything I want, I just ask Allah, oh Allah, please give me this. He said, within 3-4 minutes, I just get it. This sometimes comes from people I don't even know them. And I don't know why they know that I need even that one. And he just said, come and give it to me. He said, okay, now that you have got these things, what are you going to do now? He said, I'm now going to do more, 2 million times. He said, 2 million times? He said, yes. He said, because I am now in my final year. I'm in my final year, you know, at the university. So I'm going to do more. He did it until he said he became so tired the next day for the test. He was so tired. So he could not revise his, what is called, lessons, you know, the subject. So in the morning, said the parents told him, oh, but I was so sick, you couldn't even revise. How are you going to do this? So he said, man, don't worry. He said, why? He said, I have a weapon. You have a weapon? He said, yes. He said, what's your weapon? He said, mommy, you went to wait. When I come back, I'll tell you my weapon. Okay. He said, when I entered and they put this thing in front of me, the papers, and they said, well, just write your name and do not open it. So it opened until the supervisor said, now you can start. He said, when I open it and look at the questions, he said, wow, these questions are very, very hard. I didn't revise them at all. He said, about 5 to 10 minutes, I was sitting there and I was just making istighfar. I was making istighfar. I closed my eyes. He said, this man came to me and said, hey, are you sleeping? He said, yes, I'm sleeping in the world, but I'm awake with my Lord. So you just do your job. Look at those who are talking or who are cheating, not those, not the one who is having this. He said, after 10 minutes, when I opened my eyes, he said, something was telling me in my brain, the answers. He said, I finished all of them. Within 15 minutes, I have finished the questions that were supposed to be 1.5 hours. Because when they give us that, this is very, very, it's very long. We see within 15 minutes, he said, like something was holding my hand and just writing it. He said, when I came home, mom asked, what happened to you in your exams? He said, mom, that weapon worked. He said, what is that? I said, the istighfar. Istighfar? He said, I was able to finish all. And when the result came, he was of Mumtaz. What's the Mumtaz? Distinction. And he got, because when you get that word and so forth, they give you 3,000 riyals. And then they gave him 3,000 riyals. He said, mom, you see that? He said, what? He said, so istighfar is the greatest. That's why Ali radiallahu anhu had said, Ajibt liman yahlak wa indahu najat. He said, I'm so surprised about the one who is destroying himself and so forth, crying here and there and so forth, and that person has something that will give him the release from it. He said, what is that? He said, it's the prayer, seeking forgiveness. This is something we should practice it all the time. So, okay, Salat.
We came for Salat, Isha now. Inshallah, then we come back immediately.
Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala Rasulullah Muhammad ibn Abdullah wa ala alihi wa ashabi. My dear brothers and sisters, once more again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah accept our salah, our ibadah. May He forgive our sins and grant all of us our Jannah. Those who are sick amongst us, amongst the Muslim Ummah, wherever they are, may Allah cure them. And those who are going through trials, tribulations, problems, may Allah ease their path and grant all of us al Jannah bi ghayri hisab. Welcome to the second part after Salah of this episode today or tonight. The Sheikh, of course, was talking about Istighfar, which is our topic today. We want to look at the impact, the athar, the impact, and also as well the virtues of Istighfar. And we've learned a lot, the definition of Istighfar, the meaning, and the injunction of Istighfar, and as well, the athar, the impact, the nataij as well, some of the results, what we achieve, the results of saying istighfar. I don't want to dwell in it again. Without much ado, let me pass the mic now to the Abu Sheikh so we continue. Bi'ithnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum
assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala Ashrafil Anbiya Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Okay, let us all make istighfar 10 times, please. Astaghfirullah. Now, Alhamdulillah, let's see Quran chapter 39, which is Surah Az-Zumar, from verse 53 to 55. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said regarding this one.
Surah Zumar, chapter 39. The verse is verse 33. We're going to start. 53. We're going to start from verse 53. The chapter is chapter 39. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب بغتة وأنتم لا تشعرون الله said قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم He said say O you my servants who have oppressed wronged your souls transgressed against your souls لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله Do not lose hope from Allah's mercy Do not give up. Don't lose hope. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا Because Allah forgives all sins. إِنَّهُ Indeed He, Allah, هُوَ الْغَفُورُ He is oft forgiven. الرحيم The most merciful. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ Turn again and again to your Lord. Return again and again to your Lord. وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ And surrender, subdue, submit yourself completely, wholeheartedly. من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب Before the punishment befall on you, if you don't do that, you don't seek forgiveness, you don't turn to Him in repentance, then before the punishment comes and befall on you, ثم لا تنصرون And by then you will have no helper to save you. واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم Follow, obey the best that which your Lord has revealed unto you in this book. مِن قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابَ Before the punishment of Allah comes, بَغْتَةً suddenly, وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ Without perceiving or acknowledging or know, you know, when it befalls. Okay, that's where I stop. I thought it's in the next ayah. May Allah accept it from us.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful to us and so forgiving. And hence He said, no matter whatever sin you have committed, okay, your sins are not bigger than the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your sins are not bigger than the mercy of Allah. Nor the blessings and forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah calls us, subhanAllah, He says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina aminu, oh you who believe. That is where the message is coming to us. He said, Ya ibadiya ladhina asrafu ala anfusim. Oh my servant, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh my servant. It's like you calling your child, oh my child. Look, all what you have done and so forth, don't worry about it. I forgive you. Because at the end of the day, I am your father or your mother, isn't it? Yes. You cannot have more father or more mother than me and your mom, isn't it? So you have only one. And hence, if you have forgiven, done something wrong, I forgive you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Do not lose what? Don't lose hope in what? In the mercy of Allah. Because your sins are not bigger than the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he said, my mercy encompasses everything. And overtakes my what? My anger. So come to me. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he forgives all the sins that you think about and so forth. Once you come to me, I'll forgive you. As the Prophet has said, everybody, your sins will be forgiven once you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ma lam ta'j. As long as you do not hasten in your seeking forgiveness. So the companion said, Ya Rasulullah, my listener, ya, what is the hastiness that you are talking about here? Say, Ya Qul al-Abd, istaghfart, istaghfart. Walam ar, istaghfar, maghfiramin. I have been asking forgiveness, forgiveness, and I did not see it. And what happens to that person? What will he do? What will that person do? The person who said, I have been asked forgiveness, forgiveness, but I did not see it. Yeah. So, the person will do what? He will stop seeking forgiveness, isn't it? Yeah. And when you stop, what's happened to you? You are the loser, isn't it? You lose. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, no, you should not do that. But instead, you have to come to Allah in repentance by submitting ourselves completely to His laws. We must submit ourselves completely to His laws. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, there is no any servant who commits a sin, okay, where to tahar, and then he cleans himself. Tahar means here al-wudu. He makes wudu in the best way. And then he performs how many? Two raka'at. Wa astaghfirullah. And seeks forgiveness from? Inna ghafarallahu lahu. Except that Allah will forgive him. So someone who commits a sin and he performs wudu properly and goes with all his heart to perform two rakats. And then after that, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what? Forgiveness. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive that person. Subhanallah. This is a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is so merciful. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu had said that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are three people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates them a lot. Three people. You want to know them?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
I hope that we are not one of them. Because if Allah hates you, hey, Shaitan will love you. Yeah. When Shaitan loves you, you know the love of Shaitan. The first one is a person who deviates from the right conduct. A person who what? Deviates from the right conduct. What? How do you interpret that?
Someone goes astray.
Somebody who goes astray?
How can someone deviate from the right conduct?
When you're not doing the right thing.
Deviate from God when you're not doing the right thing.
When you're not doing the right thing? Okay. No. The one whose behavior is very, very bad.
Bad character.
Bad character. See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates that person. Then we have to be very careful. Because if Allah hates the person, Shaitan will love that person. Isn't it? Yeah, it is like that. Simple. So you must check our character, our behavior. Because according to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the heaviest thing on the scale of a servant is what? Husnul khulq, taqwa Allah wa husnul khulq. The fear of Allah and the best behavior. And if you do not have that, then Allah, according to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah hates that person. In Sahih Bukhari, he said he hates that person. So I'm sure that none of us would like to do that, isn't it? And the second one, a person who wants that, the conditions, or the customs and the traditions of the pre-Islamic period, which is what? Jahiliyyah, should remain and to be practiced. Some people, you tell them this is what Islam says, but you say, you know, our culture says this. Our tradition says that. So, yeah, Professor Asema said that person, Allah hates that person. He is the most hated person in the sight of Allah. Who wants their old customs to remain the Jahiliyan one instead of that of what? Yes. So you have to be very careful. This is this is our custom. You know, you don't do this and that. Our parents have been doing this now, this is our traditions, and so on and so forth. In some places, even the du'at who preach, they even hurt those people. Some of them, they even kill them because he's coming to preach against their culture. So Professor Sema says, these people, Allah hates them. So the first one is what?
Mm-hmm. Bad behavior.
Okay. Bad character. And the second one?
People who follow their culture and live.
Yes.
Pre-Islamic practices.
Yes. Pre-Islamic practices. The ignorance or jahiliyyah thing and so forth. And then the third one, the one who wants to shed the blood of others without what? Without right cause. That means without justice. The one who wants to shed the blood of others without? Yes. So he said these three people, Allah hates them a lot. The first one, the person who what? Who deviates from the? Yes. So the one whose character is so bad. Some people, their characters are bad. You have to be very careful. So Allah hates those people. And secondly, the one who wants the Jahiliyyah practices and so forth to remain in Islam. That is my tradition. That's our culture. This and so on and so forth. Okay. And the third one, which was the third one? The one who wants to shed the blood of? Without
justice.
SubhanAllah. So you can see nowadays, people shed the blood of others because they have power, they have this, and so on and so forth. People kill one another just like that. As if human beings are nothing. Like, you know, even a chicken, you do not even go about killing chickens, isn't it? Huh? But here you put a bomb and others on human beings, telling them, children, some of them, sometimes their head is over that side, this limb is over there. Little kid, huh? Bi'ayi zanbin qutilat. Of what sin did that child commit that you have to kill him in such bosom? So we have to be very, very careful, brothers and sisters. Now let's see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about himself. Go to Quran chapter 20. Surah 2. You know Surah Taha? Ayah 32.
Surah
Surah Taha, chapter 20. The verse is 82, not 32. Okay? Yep. Alright. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإني لغفار لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا وإني لغفار لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا ثم اهتدى. Allah said وإني verily I Allah I am لغفار I am the oft forgiven. I forgive all the time, again and again. But who? Whom did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive? He said, Liman tab. Whoever turns to me and seek forgiveness, wa aman, and they believe in me, they have faith in me. And not only that, Allah said, wa amila amalan saliha. And they act, they do actually righteous deeds. They do righteous deeds, thumma tada. They do it on the true guidance. They seek the right guidance.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about himself that he is what? Ghaffar. Ghaffar, Allah wasn't fa'al. That means someone who does something repeatedly. Repeat one over the other. And it means you make a mistake, you come back to Allah, oh Allah, please forgive me, honor this. Allah said, I forgive you. You go back again, you do another mistake, you don't like that. Allah said, I forgive you. Because one of the attributes of Allah is what? What is one of the attributes of Allah? Al-Ghafur. Isn't it? Yeah. What does that mean? The one? Who forgives not? He loves to forgive. And therefore, we should also try as much as possible to forgive. This is very important. Now, when you go to Surah 2, Ayah 221,
Baqarah.
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولا تنكح المشركات حتى يؤمن ولأمة مؤمنة خير من مشركة ولو أعجبتكم ولا تنكح المشركين حتى يؤمنوا ولعبد مؤمن خير من مشرك ولو أعجبكم أولئك يدعون إلى النار والله يدعو إلى الجنة والمغفرة بإذنه والله يدعو إلى الجنة والمغفرة بإذنه ويبين آياته للناس لعلهم يتذكرون. Allah says, ولا تنكح المشركات. Do not marry the unbelieving women حتى يؤمن, until they believe. وَلَا أَمَةٌ مُؤْمِنَةٌ, a believing woman, the slave believing women, خَيْرٌ مِّن مُشْرِكَةٌ, are more better than the unbelieving woman. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ, even if that beauty of that unbelieving woman amazed your lot. وَلَا تَنْكِهُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And Allah said, oh, you the women, the believing women, do not marry the unbelieving men. Hatta yu'minu, until they believe, until they become Muslims. Wala abdun mu'min,
A believing man, a slave believing man, khayrun min mushrik. He's more better than the mushrik, the one who joins partner to Allah. Wallahu a'jabakum. Even if that man, that his handsomeness amazes you, Allah. Ulaika yad'una ila an-nar. Why? Allah said, the unbelievers, they invite you to the fire, Jahannam. Wallahu yad'u ila al-jannah. But Allah is inviting you now to paradise. Wal maghfira. And He invites you to seek forgiveness. Maghfira. To seek forgiveness, bi'idhni, through His own permission. وَيُبَيِّنُ آيَاتِ لِلنَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains His ayat, His verses to all mankind. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ. So that they will admonish one another.
MashaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He is calling you believers to two main things. One is Al-Jannah and the next one is Maghfira, forgiveness. He said, come, I'll forgive you. Okay? So you have to make a lot of istighfar all the time. Prophet ﷺ has said, whosoever wishes that Yawm al-Qiyamah, his book will be given to him or her, and he will be very happy and show to the people, say, Ha um ikra'u kitabia. Oh, look, read my results. You know when they are, you know, for example, the students, when they go to look for their results, isn't it?
Distinction.
When they get a distinction and so forth, oh, so they go and show to their friends and so on and so forth. He said, whosoever wants that his book of deeds will be given to him in his right hand or her right hand and be very happy to show to the people, he said, alayhi and yazam istighfar kathira. Let him make a lot of istighfar. He said, make a lot of istighfar. And then one place he says, whosoever gets a lot of istighfar in his book of deeds, Yawm al-Qiyamah, then Tuba Allah. The blessed will be that particular person. It's not hard for you to do it, isn't it? Astaghfirullah. You are sitting, you are lying down, you are driving. Instead of somebody giving you a bad drive and you going to have S-words, F-words, T-words, all kind of things.
So what do you do?
What do you do? Astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. Because astaghfirullah, even before you start to drive, say astaghfirullah at least about 10 times. Why? Because it prevents you from something to happen to you. And the best istighfar, what is the best istighfar so far? That's what we are going to know now. Quran chapter 21, verse 87. The best istighfar that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said, that whosoever says that kind of istighfar, whatever problems is, things that anything that have committed, he will do what? Chapter 21.
Anbiya. Surah Anbiya.
The verse is 87.
Yeah.
Suratul Anbiya. Chapter 21. The verse is verse 87. A'udhu billahi minashaytanir rajim. وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah says, وَذَنُّون, he said, and the Nun, the companion of the fish, called who? Yunus alayhi salam. Allah said, إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا. when he left his people, they angered him because they did not believe. He was so angry and he left them without the permission of Allah. فَظَنَّ أَن لَن نَقْدِرَ عَلِيهِ. He thought that he would not have the ability to make those people what? Believe. Then he thought Allah would not like Allah had no power over him. He had to go. And then he entered into the what? The stomach of the whale or the fish. فَنَادَى. And then he cried out fi الظُّلُمَاتِ, inside the darkness of the stomach of the fish. The darkness of the world, the darkness of the sea, and the darkness of the stomach itself. Look where he was. That's where he cried. Me and you, where are we? And then he said, listen to the dua. He said, La ilaha illa ant. There is none but you. Subhanak, glory be unto you, Allah. Inni kuntu min al-thalimin. I am amongst those who have wronged their souls. That's the dua.
You have to learn this dua, you know.
You need to learn this dua, huh? Yeah. La ilaha illa ant. Subhanaka. Inni kuntu min al-thalimin. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Once more, I will say it, then you will say it yourself. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Can you say it, please? MashaAllah, I believe you said a lot of istighfar. MashaAllah, that's why you perfect this. May Allah accept it. Once more? Okay, once more. Again? In course. Again?
Very brilliant. Don't forget, you have to say this dua a lot, this istighfar, because it helps you. And Prophet ﷺ has said, nobody has any kind of a problem. And he or she says this kind of istighfar and dua, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates and takes away that kind of problem for that particular person. And I'm sure that each one of you will like to have that, inshallah.
That's what they would say tonight.
All right. Now let's see what Hud, alaykum salam, alaykum salam, Hud said to his people. Chapter 11, verse 52.
Surah Hud,
Chapter 11, verse 52. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ويا قوم استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويزدكم قوة إلى قوتكم ولا تتولوا مجرمين. سبحان الله. He said, ويا قومي. Hud said, oh you my people, istaghfiru rabbakum, seek forgiveness from your Lord. Say astaghfirullah all the time. He said, then thumma tubu ilayhi, and turn to him in repentance. If you do so, the result is this. Listen to this. He said, yursil as-samaa alaykum midrara, Allah will descend down to you abundantly all his favor. His blessings will come down, descend unto you from the sana. More, in abundance. وَيَزِدُكُمْ. He said, and with istighfar, when you say astaghfirullah, Allah will increase you what? قُوَّةً. In what?
Strength.
Power. You become stronger, you become powerful. With istighfar, you know. Subhanallah. It's not just strength. He said, quwwatan ila quwwatikum. He will increase you in strength and power. Because you are powerful right now. Because you have the iman. You have that istighfar. You have the ability to even say it. So Allah will increase you more. وَلَا تَتَوَلَّوْ مُجْرِمِينَ. Do not turn away from Allah. Huh? And become rebels. See the Quran? Huh? These are the rebels. Those who turn away from Allah without istighfar. May Allah save us from those rebels.
MashaAllah. Now let's see what Salih alayhi salam also said to his people. The same surah, verse 61.
The same surah. Surah Hud, verse 61.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. وَإِلَى ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ هُوَ أَنْشَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَاسْتَعْمَرَكُمْ فِيهَا فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ إِنَّ رَبِّي قَرِيبٌ مُجِيبٌ وَإِلَى ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. Allah said unto Thamud, the Thamud, أَخَاهُمْ, their brother, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them as a prophet, a messenger, صَالِحًا, who is صَالِح, Prophet صَالِح. قَالَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ, قَالَ, he said, يَا قَوْمِ, O you my people, اِعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah, only Allah, worship Him alone. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُ. You do not have any other God besides Him. He's the only one God you have. هُوَ أَنْشَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَاسْتَعْمَرَكُمْ فِيهَا. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has produced you from this earth and make you settle in this world. He created you from this earth and He puts you here to settle. And then He said, فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. Istighfar again. He said, seek forgiveness. Astaghfirullah. Seek forgiveness. ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. And turn to Him in repentance. إِنَّ رَبِّي. Because of verily, my Lord, قَرِيب, is closer to you than the way you think. And also as well, مُجِيب, He is always in position to answer to your dua or istighfar.
So these prophets, all of them, because it is their greatest weapon, is the greatest weapon. Istighfar, seeking forgiveness, is the greatest weapon. When in Medina there was no rain, there, you know, the place was good. And then they said, by that time Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had passed away. And Umar bin Khattab was, during that time, he was what? He was the Khalifa. So they came to him and said, look, you don't have rain and so forth, so let's make Salatul Istisqa. To ask Allah to give us what? Rain. He said, okay. Gather all the people. He gathered, they gathered the people and so forth. And he stood by the mimbar. And he told all of them, do istighfar. Istaghfirullah. And everybody, children, women, everybody make istighfar. So, when he found that they have done it, he got tired, he came down from the mimbar. He said, you came here, you told us you come to have what? Salat al-Istisqa. But you did not make us do that salat. You told us to do what? He said, yes, I did that. Because I love all of you. Because what Allah has said, nobody can make it go against that. And 10 minutes did not reach. He said, you go to Surah An-Nuh, chapter 71.
Surah Nuh, chapter 71.
Nuh alayhi salam, verse 10 to 14.
See what's Allah said.
71?
Yeah, chapter 71. Surah An-Nur. We start from verse 10. Yeah, 71, chapter 71, Surah An-Nur. We start from verse 10. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمدلكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا وقد خلقكم أطوارا. Allah said, فقلت استغفروا ربكم. He said, tell them, see, I said, seek forgiveness from your Lord. Say istighfar. Why? إنه كان غفارا. Because Allah is oft forgiven. He forgives all sins again and again. But what is the result of saying istighfar? Allah said the first thing here, when you say istighfirullah, He said, يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا. He will make the sky brings what?
Rain.
And your provision will come from up there. Make the crops, everything grow for you. He will make the sky descend or brings down rain. In abundance, midrara in abundance.
That midraran, Allah used the word midrar.
Mm-hmm.
Means something that will not come to destroy you.
Allah.
You know that some water when it comes,
flooding, isn't it? Destroying. Yeah, recently as well. Yeah, Saudi and some country as well. I saw it. Jordan. Thank you. It's the rain. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used midrara. Midrara is like when Allah said, Kuni bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. Become cold. But He did not command the fire to become cold. He said, become cold at the temperature of what? Ibrahim, become with peace. So here, the Sheikh mentioned that scene. Allah said, midrara, come down, yeah, but not to destroy at their own comfort, to give them their provision. Allah. Allah is so merciful. And that's one. And the second one, what did He say? Allah said, He will bring down the rain for you in abundance. And the second one, He said, وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالِ. Allah said, He will give you money. Allahu Akbar. When you want money, what should you do? This is the Quran, you know. Astaghfirullah. Let's say it 10 times. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. Don't worry, you'll get £10 soon.
Yeah, yes. You, look, whatever Allah has said, it is true.
Yeah.
There was one lady who came to me, and she was crying and crying and crying. I said, what's happened? She said to her husband, she was pregnant, actually. Her husband had gone to another country. And any time that she calls him, he said, no, I don't have money, don't call me again. More than 2 months, nothing was coming. Afterwards, the man even changed his number so that she would not be able to reach him. She came and was crying and crying. I said, don't cry. You know why? She said, why? I said, just make a stick fire. Do that about 1,000 times. I said, do that 1,000 times. Each day, at least. If you can do more than that, alhamdulillah. But don't go below 1,000. Can you do that? She said, yes. I gave her whatever I can give to her. She went. She said, while she was going, she was making istighfar.
Of course.
She was making istighfar, istighfar, istighfar. Until the next morning, he said, in the next morning, she got a call from the husband. She said, The number was not known to her. It's a different number. She said, who's calling me at this time? She took it. She said, yes. But she said, look, I have put money into your account. I said, you put money? She said, yes. And so, she said, anytime, this is my new number, anytime you need money, call me.
You offer something here. And you know the sisters, they said, the wives, they said, hey. Now it's to tell you, if the husband does not give the money at home, go and say astaghfirullah. Don't say you don't give money, you don't, just sit there. Don't let him know, just see your mouth mumbling like that. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. And the men, when you see the wife now keep saying like this, mumbling, keep saying, he started to say astaghfirullah, right? Anyway, let's go to the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he said verse 11, when you say istighfar, yursili samaa alaykum midrara, he will bring the rain, descend down to you from the sky above in abundance at your own pleasure. Wa yumdidukum bi amwal, Allah said, the second reward he will give you, he will stretch his provision to you, money. He used the word amwal, wealth, money, to you. And not only that, he said wa banin, and he will provide for you children as well. If you don't have children, you want children, say astaghfirullah. Allah said he will give you.
You see, Prophet Muhammad in his time, during his time, Jaa ilayhi Arabi, one Bedouin, you know, from village, he came to Prophet Muhammad and said, Messenger of Allah, in it is a waste, Ashra Sana, Ulam Unjib. I have married for 10 years. 10 years. But I do not have what? Children. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ilism istighfar. Go and stick to istighfar. The man said, since it came from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not pray for me, he didn't do anything, but he just told me this. I said, okay. He said, I went home, and myself and my wife, we make any istighfar. After 3 days, she started to have morning sickness. Oh, it comes only in the morning.
That's why.
MashaAllah, that is very pretty. It comes only in the morning.
Not after.
Then, MashaAllah, he came and he gave good news to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he got them. He said, I kept on myself and my wife. We kept on to do istighfar, hatta razaqanallah ashara abna, until Allah gave us 10 sons. Kulluhum mujahidun. All of them became mujahid. Yeah. So if you don't have children, don't cry. Make a lot of istighfar. Inshallah.
MashaAllah. You see, Allah said, wa yumdidukum bi amwal. He will stretch his wealth to you. You will earn money. Wa banin, and he will give you children. And not only that, Allah said, wa yaj'al lakum jannat. Allah will bestow on you gardens. Huh? Wa yaj'al lakum anhara. And he will bestow on you rivers of flowing water underneath. مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَرْجُونَ لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا. Why don't you seek matters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Seek protection from Him. Why don't you turn to Him? And the majesty anyway. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَدْ خَلَقَكُمْ أَطْوَارًا. Allah has created you in diverse stages. In diverse stages. May Allah accept it from us.
So you can see how nice it is. Istighfar is the greatest weapon for us. So all what you have to do, when you go to the last ayah of the same surah, look at the dua that Nuh alayhi salam made.
Same surah, surah to Nuh. Just look at the last verse of the chapter. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim.
رب اغفر لي ولوالدي ولمن دخل بيتي مؤمنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات ولا تزن الظالمين إلا تبارا.
الله said, رب اغفر لي. Nuh alayhi salam said in this ayah, he said, oh Allah, forgive me. Wali walidayy, and forgive my parents. وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِيَ مُؤْمِنًا, and for anyone believing person who enters in the house of faith or in my house of faith that believe. وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and all the believers, men, وَلِلْمُؤْمِنَاتْ, and the believing women. وَلَا تَزِدِ الظَّالِمِينَ Illa tabara. He said to the wrongdoers, grant them no more but what? Perdition. Increase them in perdition. These believers, they get increased with perdition.
So now, we are very lucky. You have the weapon, and our weapon is seeking forgiveness. When Prophet Muhammad was there, you were being protected from two main things. Can you go to Surah Al-Anfal, Quran chapter 8, verse
33. When the Prophet was alive, we have been protected from two main things. And these are the things. Surah Anfal, chapter 8. The verse is verse 33.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما كان الله ليعذبهم وأنت فيهم وما كان الله معذبهم وهم يستغفرون.
Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ. He said, Allah will not punish them while you are amongst them. You are living, you are alive, you are with them. That's the first guarantee Allah gave the Rasul ﷺ and this ummah. As long as the Rasul ﷺ is alive, Allah will not destroy them. He will give them respite to seek forgiveness. And then the second one is gonna. This is the second one guarantee Allah gave you while he's not here. He said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ. Allah said, I will not punish them. وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. As long as they say istighfar, astaghfirullah. He said, I will not punish them.
So this security too, one of them had gone. One of them had gone, isn't it? So which one you have to stick to? Why? And I said, if you stick to istighfar, I will not do what to you. You are very lucky. So you must do a lot of istighfar. A lot of istighfar. When Prophet ﷺ was going with his companions and they reached a certain place, he stopped and told the people, Istaghfirullah. Seek forgiveness. And then he kept on seeking forgiveness. He said, do it 70 times. 70. 70 times. And they did it. They said, Master of Allah, you have finished. He became quiet. He said, no one will have this opportunity by seeking forgiveness 70 times per day, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive that person. So, if he himself, alayhi salatu wasalam, used to do it but 100 times, isn't it? What about me and you? You're supposed to do it how many times? 1,000 at least. And if you can do more, the more you do, the better it's for you, isn't it? So you have to double up. You have to double up, isn't it?
Yes.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this. But Prophet Muhammad had taught us Sayyidul Istighfar. The one that you had with Prophet Yunus alayhi salam, you remember that one, isn't it? How did it go? Ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minal zalimin. He said, anyone, why? Because it comprises of three things. Can you identify the three things in that one?
Comprises of three things.
Three main things. That means, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minal zalimin. There is no one word of worship except you. Uh-huh. Glory be to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I am all doors. It comprises of three things. The first one is Tawheed. Isn't it? The first one is Tawheed. Well, what's that? The one that comes in the middle is what? Tasbih. Subhanak, tasbih, isn't it? And the last one, inni kuntu minal zalimin, istighfar. Seeking forgiveness. That's why it is so important, that particular ayah. You write it, put it in your place and so forth, and say it several times. But now, you go to the Sayyidul Istighfar that Prophet Muhammad had said. Whoever has that one, mashallah, you be the worst. Can you teach them the Sayyidul Istighfar?
He's the one who said, isn't it? He will be the one to read the Sayyidul Istighfar.
Yeah. But Istighfar,
I like that.
Istighfar, somebody can do Istighfar for you, isn't it? But nobody can do Tawbah for you.
Got it.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Do you agree to that?
Yes.
Somebody can make istighfar for you,
yes.
Ask forgiveness for you, isn't it?
Yes.
But you cannot get someone to make tawbah. Yes. Hmm?
Yes.
So he is going to do istighfar for you. That means there is no one world of worship except who? Khalaqtani. So you have created me. Wa ana abduk. And I am your what? Your servant, your slave. So now you have acknowledged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that tawheed, and then you come to acknowledge that you are also servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Isn't it? So la ilaha illa ant ita rabbi an khalaqtani wa ana abduk wa ana ala ahdik. Okay? And all the covenants that you have told me to do, to pray and so forth, I am on that. Kuwa'adik. And your promise and everything. Abu'u lak bi ni'matik alayhi. All the good things you have given to me, I acknowledge that. And likewise, bulaka bi dhanbi. My sins that I have committed and so forth, I confess that one also to you. Okay? I confess everything to you, Allah. Why? You know, innahu la yaghfiru dhunuba illa. Nobody forgives sins except who?
لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا سلام.